Well, so why did you have to get the council along?
Well, I didn't mean to. I was down at a pub last night and I was speaking to this guy who was really friendly.
You were down at a pub last night?
Yeah. Anyway, this guy was...
When did you take me?
This guy was from the council.
No, you know, were... Why didn't you take me to the pub?
Because you were busy.
I don't think I was busy. I would have remembered.
You were with your latest fling. Do you not remember? I remember. Kept me up all night with your noise.
Oh, yeah! You know what? I didn't know who that was going to be. That could have literally been anyone. That could have been Sir Lionel. That could have been Larry Barrie. Harry Barrie, maybe.
But it's Barry Barrie.
Hello, Harry Barrie.
You alright?
Sit down and watch the bowls.
What are you watching bowls for?
Remote's over there.
Look at the History Channel.
On Friday the 31st of August, 1888, Jack the Ripper officially claimed his first victim, Mary Ann Nichols. He would take the lives of four others over the next 4 months to become the most famous serial killer from around the world. He was never caught, and to this day, his identity remains a mystery. But whilst Jack was such a stir in London, another, more prolific killer was at large in the small West Midlands town of Rugby. Here, at least 20 women, mostly students, were slaughtered and butchered in such a horrific way that most could not be identified. Their bodies were hidden away in nearby woods, where it would take years for them to be discovered. It is not certain whether they've all been found. The Rugby Ripper, as he became known, was found to be a local butcher, Mark Radleford. The bloodstains on his apron were believed to be human. His punishment was that he should be burnt at the stake for his acts against humanity. With more than 1,000 people witnessing his slow and painful death, the Rugby Ripper still claimed to be innocent. As his skin slowly peeled away from his body, he raised up his head to the sky and shouted, "May God be my witness! These crimes are not my own. I will have vengeance." Many now believe that Mark Radleford was no more than a scapegoat for the failings of the incompetence of the police at the time. The Rugby Ripper, like his London namesake, still remains a mystery to this day.
So how the hell did you do all that then?
Do what?
You've only been gone for an hour. The history documentary.
Pff, I haven't done anything, mate.
We clearly did, it's not on there.
Well, I was going to do something, but it's already done.
You mean you had nothing to do with that history documentary with Larry Barrie from the council on it?
Nope. Good, aren't I?
We'd need to do extensive tests and research, and maybe even open the box.
Open the box? Are you crazy, man? Not many of us Brotherhood of Solaris members left.
Where are y'all?
Dead!
The dead?
Or worse.
This will not give everyone happiness and joy. In fact, it curses each and every three of us.
There are four of us.
I still not know the English that well.
Clearly.
I smile, yet we are all doomed.
Don't think that's your laboratory, though.
What do you mean? It is a fantabulizer!
Who are you? I'm Yronik Hausman, the Ukrainian pimp who live in your country.
Just so you don't worry, I can sense the dark spirit. I've got like a gaydar for evil. You might call it a gaydar for evil. So, I'm gonna find this dark spirit in this house. I'm gonna kill him. Kill him good. You know, I think I can track him down even if he's right behind me. We can do this, guys. Come on. Let's head out.